Well, we've turned a corner in self-esteem marketing. They're making average Barbies now that are more plain-looking than regular ones, and I think that's just great. I just love the idea of a scenario in which a little girl dreams of becoming a supermodel and her mother hands her an average Barbie like, why don't you just settle for an accountant? Hello everyone and welcome to Sunburned Albino Plays The Binding of Isaac Rebirth. I can start whenever I want. File 1, we just unlocked the negative, which means that if our runs are good enough, we can actually make it to the dark room and try to get lamb kills. And because of that, I'm going to be after some peeps. You know, Blue Baby would be the one where I could unlock the most stuff in one go, so I'm going to pick him. Let's just hope that the game obliges me by giving me good items that make this a worthy decision. That'd be real nice. One second. Yeah, there we go. I had the music down, probably a bit too low. But I fixed it, and all's good now. Okay, so they're gonna start us with tons of these asshole goddamn worms. Okay. And boy, let me tell you, it's always a real pain in the ass when you get a large room on the first floor. Because very, very rarely are you equipped to deal with it unless you are a Zazzle or a very strong Eden. So yeah, this is going to be pretty much terrible. And the thing about large rooms is that they take way longer to complete, obviously. But, like, they're not compensated by, like, a smaller floor plan. This is actually pretty good. Firemind is a really good start. It's a great starting item to build some synergies with. But, yeah, like, you know, it's not like a large room equals four smaller rooms. It does technically in size and scope, but it doesn't take away from the amount of rooms that will be on the floor. Relatively good haul. So, okay. If I had to guess where the secret room would be... it would be either under the item room or above the shop. And I'm gonna one bomb. That is not where it's at. I'm still not really good with the whole, like, in the large room, try and find the secret room stuff. Not too strong there. But I assume I'll get better eventually, but I'm only gonna get better if I practice. But I'll save my practicing for, like, you know, PS4, where, like, it doesn't... If I fail and waste bombs, it's not really a problem. But yeah, Firemind against Duke of Flies is terrific. Old Bandage as Blue Baby is pretty bad. So I suppose those two things balanced each other out. I'm going to take a drink of my root beer. Oh, it's delicious. It's 11:44 p.m. and I'm drinking root beer that has caffeine in it because sleep is for the weak. Blessed are the weak, for they shall inherit the earth. But until then, they're probably going to have a lot of bruises from being weak against people that are strong. You know, it's a game of patience. It's a waiting game. And, you know, you might be meek, but, you know, you're probably still, if you think about it, probably not going to inherit the earth in your lifetime, I would have to say. Which makes it kind of, like... Sort of, not. It's kind of a bum promise, because you're not going to be alive to inherit the Earth. I would take Anarchist Cookbook over the poop, but not for fighting bosses over it. That just seems no thank you. Okie dokie. But we've doubled our health in the past since, you know, the floor started. And that's a really good place to be in. So, really gonna be hoping for a deal with the devil that, you know, Mark Pact, things of that nature are gonna be absolutely A tier. And look at those spirit hearts. I think Rubber Cement is just fine to take. I think that's a neat synergy. It's not like the shots ever explode not on enemies. Like, if shots just exploded when they made contact with anything, that could be relatively dangerous. But I'd say that in a controlled environment, we can still make some good stuff work here. without a lot of risk, shall we say. But let's fight the long room, save the boss room for last, because we're out of keys. And it's neat, because if I ever get, like, a double shot on an enemy, there's a double the chance of them just exploding, which is real nice. This is one of those items where you want to be real far away from people. You know what would be cool is if lockpick, or whatever this trinket is called. Alright, that's not bad. Honestly, the bomb, or honestly, the secret room has to be right here. It has to be. Honestly, the secret room could have very just as easily been up here to the left or to the right. Honestly, just as easily. I mean, I knew that. We all knew that. So, there's really, nobody's really at fault for that. Thanks for dropping a live bomb that, like, hurt Monstro. I appreciate it. A real great deal. I feel like I was in the midst of saying something. That tends to happen a lot, and it's especially going to be ever more prevalent the later I go on into the evening recording stuff. And the reason I record Isaac Runs in the evening is because that's really the only time that I have time when I'm not super busy playing other video games. So, yeah. Rebirth is my nighttime pleasure. You know, that and masturbation. I'm gonna take it only because there's two black hearts here. And I mean, it's technically worth it. Little Brimstone is not as good to me as it is to other people. You know, it's a poor man's Brimstone. I mean, like, literally, technically, it is. Alright, I can open this without taking damage. Okay, that's worthwhile. That's a worthwhile trade. That's great. If I'm more careful about it, I can open it without taking damage. Like, I just tried to, like, speed through the last part, and that was garbage damage. But if I was careful on the way out as I was on the way in, then it is very doable. I'm not going to take pills anymore. I say that every time, and then I still end up taking them. I'll put my foot down. Ain't taking no more pills. The Sun card is effectively just a world card slash Necronomicon minus the ability to restore our health, considering the fact that we have no red health. So I think I'll use this at the beginning of the next floor to figure out, you know, where to go, where to affect, how to effectively tackle the floor. And I think it'll work out just fine that way. Well, we got two keys. We're not hurting on consumables technically, and we're not doing great, but we're making ends meet, putting food on the table, as my dad would say if he were poor. Okay. Okay. Dead. They're dead. Alrighty. This is worthwhile, perhaps. I mean, that makes it worthwhile, probably. Any run where I become Guppy is totally fine. Did we become Guppy on the last run, or was that the run before? I don't know, but, like, ooh, look at those explosions. Like, I don't know, but at the same time, I don't care, because I'll become Guppy any chance you want to give me. And I said I wouldn't take pills, and I believe that I've stuck to that resolve by taking all those pills. All right. Well, at least my nose hasn't started to itch. Damn it. Damn it. All right, you're dead. Something nice in here. That is a death sentence. So let's take it. And actually, our range is still pretty good. And that's kind of not making sense to me. Like, maybe Bouncing Tears is like a big range upgrade. Because not only did I get number one, but I got a range down pill. So it's like, oh, what? But okay, the secret room can't be on the right side of this room. But it's not there either, wow. Alright. Could it be... It can't be on the right side there either, so it has to be here. This is the only place that it can be. Thank you for making me sound semi-smart that I'm using some kind of logic to make this work, because the game has been intent on proving me wrong in certain instances where I would much rather have been proved correct. All right, you're dead. Oh, great. Damage and range. All right, we're at starting range, I'd say. Like, basic range that you get with a basic life. And that's a good place to be at when you're at when you've got number one. Got that damage and range. I love the way the fire tears look when they're blood clots, because they're like red fire and it looks evil and nasty. Spooky. I don't want none of that. I have not visited a shop this entire run yet, and that's because I've had no money. I have some money, but not a lot. I'm implementing a new policy when it comes to shop, or when it comes to donating specifically. I'm gonna donate on the last shop all my money. Really? If you think I don't think this is worth it, you're out of your goddamn mind. And also, I only took one damage. I fully expected to take two, and I still would have considered it worth it. Beautiful. Also, thank you, Revengefly, for blocking that shot that I totally should have been hit by. That is Ball of Tar. I am essentially Gish now. Does it affect certain shots, or is it like just a continuous effect? Because my shots still all look the same. I would assume that like some of them would turn black or something. Something of that nature. But that's okay. Pills are bad, so I'm going to waste a bomb to try to get some. Alright, well, I'm glad I went through with that. Oh, there's a black flame shot. It's very, very rare, it appears. That's fine, you know? Anything that makes our tears look cool is totally what I want. Yeah, we're on Catacombs 2. Might as well just fight the boss now. Alright, so they're dead. Boss fight, relatively easy. HP ups are not my favorite. But at least... Okay, I'll tell you. Please give me Krampus's head. God damn it. I would have really loved Krampus's head over the poop. I think we all could understand why. I don't think boss rush mode is worth doing as Blue Baby unless you have Dark Bum or you're, like, immensely powerful. Because you can't refill your spirit hearts. I'm going to go in here, though. And it might end up being worth it. Come on. Damn it. I think I can blow up all four of them. Yeah, I placed them close enough that you can do it with one bomb, but you got to be mildly risky with it. All right, but I'm liking our damage. I think this could... If we get, like, a few more... Well, okay. If we get either a few more offensive upgrades or if we get Dark Bum, I'd say we've got a really, really good shot at the lamb. All right. I hate Mega Fatty. Some of these new bosses just really... like to hit me. Like that freaking bullshit jump that I'm just lucky I didn't get hit by. Oh, bullshit. Mega Maw is actually one of my favorite bosses, and I used to think that I was good at dodging his attacks. I still do, but that's a poor example. Well, we've only got one bomb, and it can't be there. I want to find it. I do. It could be there. Let's not rule that out yet. It could still be there. Could we look on downwards? And it cannot actually be there, which means there's actually a good chance that it's connecting the shop and the curse room, in which case it's not worth going in. So we'll go to Depths 1. And Depths 1 is where we're going to fight, or when we're, where we're going to open the shop, regardless of how much money we have. Because I have to figure out if greed's in that shop. Because if greed is in that shop, then that means I'm donating all my money on Depths 2. If greed is not in that shop, that means I have to donate all my money on Depths 1, because there's a chance that greed would be in Depths 2 shop, which would take out the donation machine, which would make it impossible for me to donate anything. So it's simple yet complex. It's, like, it's long, but, like, it's pretty easy to grasp, I would say. Oh, you guys. You guys, and you're taking half my health. This room. Alright, at least it was just that. Apparently I'm not fast enough to get by these guys. I go. That bomb's not worth trying to get. This run went south real fast, actually. I lost a lot of health in the last two rooms. And this doesn't look great. I was alright. You know, it's dangerous to be up close to these enemies. I need Pyromaniac. That's what I need. Pyromaniac would be a game-saving item. Oh, shit. Oh, yeah, good. I really needed him to not explode there, and he did not, so that was nice of him. But some of these other guys are not being so generous with their non-explosiveness. Okay, I'm opening this. That was well worth it. That's pretty good. Got lots of money for the shop. Attack fly, great. Give me three more fly items, and I'll be like, okay, well, that was nice that you did that for me. I'll buy those options. I have to donate all my money here. All five of my money here. Because there's a great chance that greed's going to be in the next shop. I should have bought a spirit heart. I should have bought a spirit heart. All right, lucky guess there. Based on no information that I could have easily gained if I just explored the map just a little tiny bit and remembered the layout of floors. Because remember, secret rooms can only be in the middle of rooms where it's accessible to get to them from every angle. From every angle that there's a room. So, like, in that case... Oh, Jesus. All, you know, left, upwards, and right were all able to get into the secret room. But not bottom, because there wasn't a room there. Which, there didn't need to be one there. Oh, what the fuck? Oh, because it's hitting freaking the little chub and exploding. That's garbage. I hate that. I wish that never happened. Remember when I said I was going to use the sun card at the beginning of this floor? I didn't do that. And now it's too late. Oh, fuck me. That's on me. That is on me. Oh, close calls. If there's been tinted rocks, I've been missing them. And I'd feel bad about it if I did, but I don't think I've been missing them. So let's go fight the boss, because it's dangerous as... Figures. The one boss that has the highest chance to murder me. Oh my god. Oh god. Sun card. Are you fucking kidding me? Oh, god damn it. Well, that's going to do it for this episode. I hope you enjoyed it. There's no reason for you to have. But, yeah. If you like, share, and subscribe. And that's the first time I've died in a long time. Like, share, and subscribe. And I will see you guys next time.